the last two decades, we start seeing some improvement in how society becomes more accepting of the LGBTQA+ community, especially in the Americas and Western European countries. Unfortunately, in other parts of the world, such as Eastern Europe, Middle Eastern, and the majority of Asian countries, there is a lot of injustice for the LGBTQA+ community. Religion and norms are a couple of biggest reasons why people are not open to homosexuality. How is it to be gay in the biggest Muslim population in the world? Welcome to my podcast. This is Gloria Angeline. I have a story of lesbian couple which one of them works in the Indonesian military. Unfortunately, they have to choose between love or career. I'm talking with Azalia over a Zoom call about her relationship with Lily. I reach out to see if Lily would like to join us, but she does not respond.
This is going to sound so weird because I remember everything vividly.
Azalia is a sport reporter and Lily was a promising athlete.
You know, back in August, September 2018, Indonesia was the host for Asian Games.
And this is the Asian Games theme song that they play over and over again during that event.
And I was looking for Indonesian athlete.
It must be crowded there. How did you spot the Indonesian one?
She wore red and white shirt stating Indonesia, so I know for sure she's from Indonesia with a bunch of her friends. I did not think we're gonna meet again, and I bumped into her.
Did you prepare for this?
Whoa, I look like shit. I haven't been showering, if I'm not mistaken.
And things happens from there. Azalia sent me this digital album of her and Lily.
It's been love you.
Yes, that's Lily. The album is full of photos and videos of them working out together, hanging out with friends, cuddling, kissing, and more kiss. But as I scroll down further, things get a little off. Since Lily shows up in a military uniform, their romantic moment that was intense is now non-existent. It really makes me sad to hear Azalia cries. I need to ask her about this.
Hey, I saw the folder you sent me. What's happening?
Oh my god, this is so hard. Since October 9th, she texted me like, hey, please just don't reach me, don't text me, don't DM me. And then I saw on social media, on Instagram, she could repost a lot of shit and she could call some of her friends. And why not me?
A couple of weeks before that, Lily told Azalia that she would go through the military entrance test and she wouldn't be able to use her phone. She also told Azalia to wait for her and that she loves Azalia. Nothing sounds unusual until the test is over.
Even though we were mad at each other, we still like say, hey, good morning, I'm not in the mood of talking to you. But, you know, let's settle this later on. Yeah, or fight just a little bit. But we always talk to each other. So that was weird.
For about 6 months, Lily does not talk with Azalia. Just sometimes, Lily tries to reach out from random phone numbers.
And all of a sudden, she got back with her ex, who is also in the military, her male ex. And yeah, it hurt. I have no idea that we're going to break up because we love each other that much. I felt like we love each other that much.
You put emphasis on male ex. Are you trying to tell me something?
Okay. I'll tell you the background story, how she entered the military. First of all, you have to do the test, right?
One of the tests is virginity test. Here's a soundbite from a Human Rights Watch activist.
In Indonesia, women who wish to apply for the National Police Force have to undergo a virginity test. This testing is invasive and abusive, and it has no bearing on their ability to be a good police officer.
The virginity test is actually for both police and military force. The purpose is to check if the candidates are having good morals or no. Another moral test is to make sure that nobody in the military is falling under any LGBTQA+ categories.
in Indonesian military, you're not allowed to be LGBTQ+. You could get prosecuted, or maybe you could lose your job.
There is no law that criminalized homosexuals, but back in 2017, 141 people were arrested from a gay club in Indonesian capital Jakarta and prosecuted under Indonesia's pornography law. Lily is worried that she would be kicked out of the military for being gay. The main reason is because she does not want to disappoint her parents because it's their dream for her to be in the military.
How did people in the military find out that she's gay?
They snooped into her cell phone.
Where did you get this idea from?
She told me. I'm not sure I could like share this, but yeah, well, I'll tell you anyway.
Within the 2 weeks military entrance test, all candidates must collect their phones. That's a critical time when the military people do background check by going through all candidates' photos and text messages. Anyone who passed this phone screening will be interviewed for around 20 minutes, but Lily was being interviewed for around 5 hours.
Are you telling me that she's being interrogated? What did they ask her in 5 hours?
I have no idea. She did not explain everything in details because she's in the military. It's supposed to be a secret what they're doing inside there.
Well, I suppose there shouldn't be any secret in this case. But anyway, do you think she loves her boyfriend?
I asked her, did you love him? And she said, honestly, no, I don't. The friend of that boyfriend told me that she did not want to hold that guy's hand.
Do you think she still loves you?
I do. We meet. She still kissed me.
They finally find a way to communicate and to meet. This is a video of Lily in a military uniform when she goes out with Azalea.
Minal aizin wal faizin. McDonald mengucapkan.
Kok McDonald? Pegang Starbucks, goblok.
But why you break up anyway?
Because, you know, she does not grow up in a society where being gay is okay. She thinks that it's wrong. Her family wants her to get married. The society demands her to get married.
In Indonesia, only opposite-sex marriage that's legal and accepted in the society.
One time, she asked me though, if I do want to get back together, what should I do? She asked me that.
And what did you say?
If you do want to get back together, you should fight for me. I fought enough, so it's your turn now. She want to maintain being the goody girl everyone is look up to, even though I know deep down she's not that person.
Do you think she will marry a man?
In the near future, yes. She already has a new boyfriend.
So are you going to be the person who always be there for her that she can always look up to when she's not with her boyfriend or future husband?
No, I don't want that. I mean, I know my worth. I know I deserve to be with someone. Oh, I'm gonna cry. I deserve to be someone who's proud to be with me. This is hard, like I'm sure. Yeah, I mean, I know that she still loves me in a way, and I still love her, but She does not want to fight, so why should I be with someone who does not, you know, want to be with me, like fight for me? So it's not fair, even though I do love her until now, but I don't see it happening.
Not long after this interview, Lily posts a photo of her and her new boyfriend that she's going to marry. This is how this invalid moral test does not benefit the LGBTQA+ community. Many of them would give up their relationship to be morally acceptable and to keep their job. To be happy shouldn't be this hard.